Hello and welcome back. This again is Ed Gibson, and it's my privilege here to introduce session three of the second day. This is the last of our presenting sessions. I'll wrap things up after this one is over. And we've had two terrific sessions already today. We got the UK perspective on prevention through design and CDM, and then last hour we were talking of the Vera Rubin Observatory project, a very large project from the NSF and DOE, and how they've used system safety to focus on hazard recognition and reduction on their projects. And I think you're going to really find this next presentation to be a great presentation. It's Mortenson Company, and they are using a lot of innovative methods to get towards zero accidents, and it's all tied in to prevention through design. So it's my distinct pleasure to introduce to you our moderator for the session. Many of you know him, TJ Lyons, and TJ has been engaged in our steering committee for a number of years. He's a dynamic speaker on his own, and has been engaged. He's at DPR Construction, working on many of the things that we've talked about today, and he's been engaged in the safety arena and prevention through design for a number of years. So I'll just turn it over to TJ now, and we'll get him to introduce our speakers and the subject.
Thank you, Ed. Afternoon, everyone. And this is like the coolest part of my job, right, is to share these best practices and things that we run across in life. And in fact, I'm on a project today where they're talking about lifting up components to a steel building, four trusses at a time with a deck already in place, something we wouldn't have envisioned a couple of years ago. And that's kind of, I'm very excited to talk about the presentation today by Jason and Justin. So they've been doing this for a couple of years. And one of the reasons we brought them on board here was to answer a couple of things. Number one is, yes, you can get to zero. And if you don't believe you can't get to zero, look at what the airplane industry has done over the last 10 years. But also, they're going to answer what's in it for me. When you look at the presentation, take some notes, but listen very carefully, because they're kind of proving what we've been hoping, which is through prevention, through design, you know, safety is good, but we're going to get a lot of profit. We're going to make some time and schedule, and it's going to be a lot easier for the people to do the work. During the presentation that's going to be coming up and offered out here, feel free to put chat notes in chat, things you want to talk about. But if you have real questions, put them in the Q&A, and we'll be discussing those at the end of the presentation. So without spending any more time on this, we do have a clock running. I'm going to turn over to Jason and Justin to answer what's in it for me through this journey to zero they put together for us.
Checking my vital signs, drawing my battle lines, going to war again. Feeling the rhythm inside of my chest, all I need is just a pen. I know I was born for this. I know I was born for this.
Hello, and welcome to this presentation, A Journey to Zero, a case study on the application of design for manufacturing and prevention through design to drive a zero injuries culture. In this presentation, we will be taking a look at specific examples of manufactured products, their application on our projects, and the results they have provided. My name is Jason Hopper, and I am the director of DFMA for Mortenson Construction. In this role, I support the development and implementation of manufactured products on our projects and partner with customers to find new ways to industrialize the construction process. I am joined today by Justin Riley. Justin is the field operations manager for our hyperscale data center market. In this role, he has overall responsibility for the execution of work on Mortenson's data center projects and ensures that each project is completed in accordance with design, budget, schedule, and quality standards. For those who may not be familiar with Mortenson, I wanted to provide a brief overview of the organization as we start. The company was founded in 1954 in Minneapolis, Minnesota, and has grown to become one of the top 20 builders in the United States. With annual revenues close to $5 billion and over 5,000 team members, the company operates in 12 regional offices and across more than 20 different industries. Over 40% of the annual revenue comes from renewable energy markets such as solar, wind, battery storage, and power delivery construction. The remaining work includes more traditional commercial construction and real estate services. Within the past 5 years, the construction of hyperscale data centers has represented an ever-increasing amount of the annual revenue and will be the focus for our conversation today. You may be asking yourself, exactly what is the hyperscale data center market? To answer that question, I wanted to provide a backdrop of the business case that is driving this capital construction market. As our world continues to demand real-time, anywhere solutions for technology, the need for data storage and processing in cloud environments is growing exponentially. This cloud environment, in this case referred to as the data sphere, is currently estimated to contain around 70 to 80 zettabytes of data. And what is a zettabyte, you might ask? A zettabyte is equivalent to 1 billion terabytes. Future projections for the data sphere estimate the need for data storage and processing to be at 175 zettabytes in only 3 more years. And even as astounding as that sounds, this will represent only about half of all worldwide data. This exponential demand is fueling a corporate response from several large technology firms who are investing in the real bricks and mortar of the cloud. One of the largest firms engaged in hyperscale data center construction is Meta. Mortenson has the honor to be part of the Meta program, which spans across almost 20 campuses in the United States and Europe. The pace of construction across these campuses is increasing dramatically in order to meet the future demand of the data sphere, and reliable delivery of server capacity is essential to meeting this business need. One of the challenges to delivering these projects at the pace and scale involved is the availability of skilled labor on the construction sites. Specifically, each of these projects can take more than 500 craft workers from electrical, plumbing, sheet metal, and pipe fitter trades to deliver. When you consider that Meta is delivering on 10 to 15 projects concurrently, and that several of their peers in the hyperscale space are doing the same thing, it becomes apparent that we must find new ways to diversify the location of labor necessary for construction. Thus, we have partnered with Meta to develop manufactured components, which allow for labor to be completed off-site and then installed as an assembly on-site. This provides relief of labor demand as well as safety, quality, and schedule benefits. I would like to now have Justin share the first of our examples of manufactured products, precast concrete duct banks.
All right. As you can see here in the slide, this is one of our DSMA products, the precast duct bank. This incorporates both power and telecom raceways, and with the substantial amount of duct bank required for both within a typical data center, specifically with our customer design, we wanted to make it not only safer, but made much easier to install for the craft. By doing so, one, we have made the install safer and easier for the craft, two, reduce the amount of electrical resources required on site, and assuming a lot of you have seen the strained resources in today's construction environment, three, improve overall quality, and four, lastly, increase schedule reliability. To better understand the duct bank, we have a quick video to share on the next slide.
Hi, I'm Dylan Van Avery, and I'm very excited to present to you a very unique and innovative process that Mortenson is implementing to better serve a customer of ours building a hyperscale data center here in beautiful DeKalb, Illinois. The first product we're focused on here at the facility is the underground precast duct bank. And in case you're unfamiliar with what a precast concrete duct bank is, picture Legos, but these ones are long, skinny, and heavy, made out of concrete and conduit. So there's a lot of little nuances and details in how the actual duct banks are made, but the general overview goes like this. We have the formwork system that allows us to automate the process significantly. It rides down the rails, over the conduit and rebar cages. We're able to then pour concrete into the boxes. We let them cure up. Then next day, we're able to break open the forms, take the bulkheads off, and voila, we've got a complete precast duct bank in less than 24 hours. And in less than 2 days, we can load these onto trucks and ship them down to site, where Aldridge Electric takes over. Because the precast duct bank is so simple to install, they're able to just grab that duct bank off the truck using a backhoe, drop it in the correct location in the trench, and then stack them like long, skinny Legos down the line from vault to vault. They then backfill in lifts, compact that soil up until we get back to grade, and voila, you've got a completed duct bank run. So the major advantages of doing a precast duct bank start with safety. The lack of variables, the lack of weather, the controlled environment produces a much safer environment to work in for our folks. Another advantage of fabricating the duct banks in the facility behind me is the consistency. Because we have a lower number of variables in this environment, we are able to control the outcomes at a much better rate. In fact, we have much fewer defects that we find in our inspections in this setting than we would in a site setting. The last major benefit that I want to touch on is efficiency. And there's two types of efficiency. There's the schedule impact and the labor hours associated with producing duct bank in a manufacturing facility. And the good news is we see a benefit for both. In the manufacturing setting, we're not at the mercy of all the variables associated with the traditional construction process. This allows for more reliable schedule outcomes, as well as a reduction in the labor hours. Well, I hope this gives you a great overview of what it takes to build and install a precast duct bank. And I really look forward to showing off some of our future products that we have in store.
Now you have a better understanding of the precast duct bank. You can see in the slide a typical stick build scenario on the left and a precast install on the right. One thing to recognize here is a difference of the install. One, 53% less in overall craft labor by incorporating the precast solution, which means a lot less craft in the field getting in and out of the trenches, which equals less safety incidents. Two, schedule reliability. We seen an overall schedule savings on our first build incorporating on the TCON scope by 4 months. So not only were we able to decrease the schedule by 4 months, but with reducing the electrical resources by 53% as well, helped get us to the zero safety incidents on our first build incorporating this.
The next product that we would like to highlight is manufactured interior wall panels. These interior partitions are fabricated in an off-site factory and include all electrical, security, and fire alarm systems and are faced with one side of gypsum drywall. Once completed in the factory, the 25-foot tall panels are loaded onto a flatbed truck and shipped to the project site where they are installed with the use of traditional forklifts and a small setting crew. Let's take a look at a short video from our trade partner, Western Partitions, that helps to illustrate this process. With close to 500 panels on each building, the utilization of the manufactured wall panels on our projects have provided many benefits. Starting with the work in the manufacturing facility, we have made many changes to the assembly line to create more ergonomic and safer workspaces for our craft team members. One example of this can be seen in the image on the screen. In the video, you saw the use of blue, what we call whirly bird carts, to take the panel from a horizontal position, which is most advantageous for framing, to a vertical position, which is more beneficial for electrical work inside the wall. With continuous improvement in mind, our team has now automated this process with the use of a motor-driven tilt table. This allows for more control of the panel and also gives greater working position adjustment for ergonomics. Another safety improvement in the factory setting that we are implementing is the use of pre-punched metal stud framing members. This allows for us to eliminate the need for any cutting operations in the panel assembly process, as all of the studs are cut to length and pre-dimpled for the location of the screwed connection. As we consider the benefits of these panels on the project site, the most obvious safety advantage that these panels provide is the elimination of work at heights. More than 50% of the work required in these walls traditionally occurs at an elevation greater than 6 feet. With the manufacturing process, we have eliminated that exposure and now are able to complete this work from floor level. Finally, the use of these panels has reduced the labor requirements on site for completing framing and rough-in activities. The workforce required on site is a crew of four, which minimizes safety exposures not only for this operation, but also for other on-site work.
As you can see here, this is a precast grade beam that our trade partner Suntech brought to us early on in our DFSMA journey. And one thing that we recognized by doing this is it eliminated the risks of, once again, like the precast duct bank, it eliminated the risk of getting in and out of areas carrying rebar, formwork, and placing concrete. And by doing this, we were able to do this in a controlled environment, placing the concrete, forming it up, you know, placing the rebar. All those items were done in a controlled environment. And what we've done is we've been encouraging other trade partners in the concrete industry to follow this lead. And once again, they kind of revert back to their old ways and just doing it as they've always done. And the reason I like to use this as an example is at one of our other sites, our concrete trade partner, not to pick on them, they want to go the old way. And by doing so, they were increasing labor, when my eyes, increases risks. So these individuals were having to walk through mud, through excavations, placing bar, forming it up. But we had an individual that literally slipped and fell in the mud while he was stripping formwork in the field and cracked his vertebrae. And so I really wanted to relate how the DFSMA products that are in a controlled environment help eliminate that risk. By doing it, doing less in the field is going to improve overall safety for all your projects. I just wanted to share this as a real life example. One thing also we want to emphasize that is part of our foundation of our culture is our 5S program. And if I can leave our message to all of y'all with one thing, is that whether you implement a true 5S or just truly buy into what a clean, organized project site looks like, if you do not have a clean and organized project, you're probably going to have safety issues. So if I can leave you one thing to implement on all your projects is the 5S. That means it will be a safer project overall. And as you implement DSFMA into your projects and along with 5S, that foundation will always be there and your jobs will be ultimately safer by utilizing this. And that's it.
We hope that you have enjoyed our presentation today about how we are using manufactured products and prevention through design to eliminate hazards, improve ergonomics, and create the best working environment for our craft team members. As we continue on this journey, we must remember that at the center of all of our efforts are the women and men in the field who are putting the work into place. These are the real heroes of the construction industry, and these are the people who create the built environment. It is not our choice, but our obligation to find new ways to make their work safer so that they may continue the important work of construction. It is our commitment to these craft workers to ensure a workplace that provides the safest and cleanest environment to practice their craft and contribute to the successful completion of our projects. Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you very much, you guys.